हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ पूजा गुप्ता एंड आई एम अ सीनियर रिसर्च एसोसिएट इन बेरिस्पायर। सो टुडे सेशन इज अबाउट हाउ टू रीड अ पेटेंट डॉक्यूमेंट, एज मोस्ट ऑफ अस फाइंड डिफिकल्टी इन रीडिंग द पेटेंट डॉक्यूमेंट बिकॉज वी आर नॉट फेमिलियर मोस्ट विद द मोस्ट ऑफ द टर्म्स यूज इन द पेटेंट डॉक्यूमेंट। सो आई होप आफ्टर दिस सेशन इट वुड बी बिट इजियर फॉर एवरी वन टू अंडरस्टैंड द पेटेंट डॉक्यूमेंट। सो आर फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज अबाउट द पेटेंट डॉक्यूमेंट। सो पेटेंट डॉक्यूमेंट इज बेसिकली अ टेक्नो लीगल डॉक्यूमेंट एंड इट इज अ मेजर सोर्स ऑफ अ टेक्नोलॉजिकल एंड कम्पिटेटिव इंफॉर्मेशन। नाउ वाई आई कॉल्ड द पेटेंट डॉक्यूमेंट एज अ मेजर सोर्स ऑफ अ टेक्नोलॉजिकल एंड कम्पिटेटिव इंफॉर्मेशन बिकॉज अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 80% ऑफ द अवेलेबल टेक्निकल इंफॉर्मेशन इज पब्लिश्ड इन पेटेंट्स। देयरफॉर इट इज इक्वली इम्पॉर्टेंट टू नो दैट हाउ टू रीड अ डॉक्यूमेंट एज वेल एज हाउ टू फेच अ डॉक्यूमेंट। एंड ऑल्सो पेटेंट इंफॉर्मेशन इज यूजफुल फॉर एनी पर्सन। इट कैन बी अ टीचर, स्टूडेंट, प्रोफेसर एंड एनी वन हु वॉन्ट्स टू वर्क ऑन देयर न्यू टेक्नोलॉजीज और वॉन्ट्स टू डू सम इम्प्रूवमेंट ऑन द एग्जिस्टिंग टेक्नोलॉजीज। नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द पेटेंट डॉक्यूमेंट। बेसिकली एवरी पेटेंट डॉक्यूमेंट इज कैटेगराइज टू हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ डेटा। वन इज द बिब्लियोग्राफिक डेटा एंड सेकेंड वन इज द टेक्निकल इंफॉर्मेशन और वी कैन से द टेक्निकल डेटा। एंड वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट बोथ टाइप्स इन द फर्दर स्लाइड्स। एंड नाउ फॉर नाउ वी कैन विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड विच इज अबाउट द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ रीडिंग अ पेटेंट डॉक्यूमेंट। सो द फर्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ रीडिंग अ पेटेंट डॉक्यूमेंट इज लाइक इट हेल्प्स समवन इन गेटिंग एन अपडेट ऑफ द न्यू टेक्नोलॉजीज एंड फ्रॉम देयर द पर्सन कैन थिंक ऑफ सम इनोवेटिव आइडियाज। ऑल्सो द रीडिंग अ पेटेंट डॉक्यूमेंट हेल्प्स अस टू नो द प्रायर आर्ट्स। इट ऑल्सो अवॉइड्स द डुप्लीकेशन ऑफ रिसर्च बिकॉज इफ द इन्वेंशन विच द पर्सन इज गोइंग टू फाइल इज ऑलरेडी पेटेंटेड देन देयर इज नो बेनिफिट ऑफ फाइलिंग द सेम इन्वेंशन बिकॉज इट वुडंट बी कंसिडर्ड एज अ नॉवल। However, by reading the patent document, which are similar to your invention, one can do the further improvements on that invention, which in turn makes the invention novel, and then the person can file that patent with the novel feature. And also, there are some other importances of reading the patent document. For example, if anyone wants to work on some existing technology, then reading the patent document will also help him in finding the loophole, and then he can do improvements on that technology. And once the person is familiar with the existing technologies, he can prevent the claims with a proper scope of the invention. Further, there is one more importance of reading a patent document, like he avoids the patent infringement. Because nowadays in the competitive industries, it is very important to know the parallel technologies so that infringement proceedings can be avoided. Therefore, it is very important to get updated with the latest developments in the field of technology, and that we can achieve by reading the patent document. Now, moving on to the further slide. So as we discussed earlier that the patent document basically has two types of data, and the first one is the bibliographic data. Bibliographic data is basically the basic data in relation to the invention, we can say, which covers various fields. For example, the title of invention, publication number and date, IPC classification code, application number, application filing date, priority number, priority date, priority country, field of invention, inventor details, grant date, and patent number, and so forth. We will discuss about each of these particulars in detail in further slides. And the next one is about the second type of data or technical information, we can say. It is basically about the invention, and it is also comprises the details which are associated with the invention. It also comprises various particulars or fields, we can say. For example, the title of invention, field of invention, background of the invention, summary of the invention, description of drawings, detailed description of the invention, abstract, and last one is claims. Now, we'll also discuss about these particulars in details in coming slides. And now we are moving to the next slide, which is about the bibliographic data. So here I am taking an example. Here I am taking an illustration of the Indian patent application courtesy to the applicant. This information is taken from the Indian Patent Office website. And now here we can see the bibliographic data, and the first field is the title of the invention, which indicates a subject matter of the invention. And the next field is the publication number. Publication number is provided by the patent office, Indian Patent Office, once the application is published. And the next field is the publication date. Publication date is the date on which the application is published by the patent office. And next field is the publication type. Publication type is basically indicates that the patent is published, not yet granted. And further, there is an application number. Application number, which is allotted by the patent office once the patent is filed. And then there is the application filing date. And application filing date is the date on which the application is filed. And further, there is the priority number. Priority number is the number of application in respect to which the priority is claimed. And further, there is a priority country. Priority country is a country in which an applicant first files an application or their invention. It can be any country where the first application is being filed. And further, there is a priority date. Priority date is the date on which an inventor first file a patent application in respect to the invention. Now let's take an example of the priority number, priority country, priority date, and the application number for better understanding. For an instance, if a person first filed an application in a country, for example, Korea, on a date 11 January 2019, and then filed the same application in another country, for example, India, on 21st September 2019. So in that case, the priority number is the number which is provided by the patent office for the first filed application, and the application number is the number which is provided by the patent office for the second filed application. Now, next field is about the field of invention. Field of invention is about whether the invention is of the chemical, mechanical, computer science, or any other branch of technology. Further, there is a classification. Basically, Indian Patent Office follows the IPC classification, and IPC stands for International Patent Category, and it followed by the patent office of many countries to classify the content of the invention so that the retrieval of information about the particular invention is done in a uniform manner or uniform way. And next one is the inventor. Now, who are the inventors? Inventor is the one who has contributed in the invention. There can be a one inventor, there can be multiple inventors, which we called as the co-inventors, who all have contributed for the invention. And next, there is an applicant. An applicant is a person who has a right to file an application for the invention. Now, let's take an example of inventor and an applicant. For an instance, if a school student is making an invention, then that school student is called the inventor. एंड द इन्वेंशन विच इज मेड बाय द स्कूल स्टूडेंट इज फाइल्ड बाय द स्कूल देन इन दैट केस दैट स्कूल इज द एप्लीकेंट ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ दैट स्टूडेंट. नाउ वी आर मूविंग टू द फर्दर स्लाइड. सो previous one is about the published data of the bibliographic data and this one is the data of the granted data. Here I am taking an illustration of the granted Indian patent. In the granted Indian patent there are few additional particulars we can say, such as patent number, application number, type of application, date of patent, date of grant, date of recordal and so on. So we'll start with the first one, which is the patent number. So patent number is basically assigned by the patent office after the grant of the patent and it is a unique identification patent number. Next one is the application number. Application number, as we already discussed in the previous slide, which is allotted by the patent office once the patent is filed. Further, there is a type of application. Type of application indicates whether the application is a national phase application, PCT application, and if the application is the PCT application, then it will also include PCT international application number and PTC international filing date. Further, there is a grant title. Grant title is basically the title of the granted patent. And further, there is a date of patent. Date of patent is the filing date on which the patent is filed. And next one is the date of grant. Date of grant is the grant date on which the patent is granted. And further, there is a date of recordal. Date of recordal is usually the same as the date of grant, but it can vary. We can't say it always same as the date of grant. Next is the appropriate office. Appropriate office is the office where the application has been filed. It can be a Kolkata, Chennai, Mumbai, Delhi or Nagpur. Then further, there is a name of grantee and this name of patentee. A grantee is a person who gets a grant on the filed application, and patentee is a person for the time being entered on the register as the grantee or the grantee of the patent. And now we are moving to the next slide, which is about the technical information. As I have already told that the patent document has some technical information which describes about the invention and the details associated with the invention. Now here I am taking an illustration of an Indian patent application where the first section is the title of the invention, which tells us about the subject matter of the invention. For an instance, in this patent application, the title tells us that the invention is related to a method for real-time prediction of water quantity, powder quantity in additive manufacturing. Further, there is a next field of invention. Field of invention basically tells us about the broader area in which the invention belongs. For an instance, in this patent application, the field of invention indicates the additive manufacturing. Next, there is a background and the prior art. So basically, background tells us what are the issues in the already patented or the published document, where the document can be a patent or it can be a research paper or any other written document. Background also tells us about the prior arts, what are the existing technologies and so on. For example, here in the paragraph number 004, it is mentioned that the conventionally the powder required for completing the manufacturing is pre-calculated logically, wherein slight miscalculations can lead to loss of production and valuable resource. So this is one of the issue which the inventor is trying to solve in his invention. Next is the objects. Next are the objects and the summary. Objects and summary could be under one header or it could be under different headers. But in this illustration of the patent application, objects and summary are under different headers. So firstly, we'll discuss about the objects. बेसिकली द ऑब्जेक्ट्स शुड क्लियरली ब्रिंग आउट द इन्वेंशन टू बी अचीव्ड बाय द इन्वेंटर और द इन्वेंशन वी कैन से. ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑल्सो टेल्स अस दैट वॉट इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द इन्वेंशन, वॉट इज द पर्पज ऑफ द इन्वेंशन और वॉट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ द इन्वेंशन. फॉर एन इंस्टेंस इन दिस पेटेंट एप्लीकेशन द फर्स्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द इन्वेंशन इज टू प्रोवाइड अ मेथड फॉर प्रिडिक्टिंग क्वान्टिटी ऑफ पाउडर इन एडिटिव मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. सिमिलरली अनदर ऑब्जेक्टिव वुड बी द मेथड ऑफ प्रिडिक्टिंग रियल टाइम क्वान्टिटी ऑफ पाउडर इन एडिटिव मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. सो दीज आर सम ऑब्जेक्टिव और वी कैन से पर्पज ऑफ द इन्वेंशन विच दे आर ट्राइंग टू डू इन द इन्वेंशन. एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज द समरी. सो समरी इज बेसिकली is which is provided before giving the details of the invention and the method of performing it. Summary should contain some distinguishing features of the invention for which the protection is desired, and it is also intended to declare different aspects of the invention. Now we are moving forward to the next slide. That is about the brief description of drawings and the detailed description of the preferred embodiment. So in the brief description of drawings, drawings are basically the part of detailed description only and should be enlisted properly. And further, there is a detailed description of the preferred embodiment. So a description of the invention gives a complete picture of the invention and follows the summary of the invention. Moreover, the description should clearly and sufficiently describe the improvements effected with respect to the prior arts. It may or may not include examples or drawings or both for clearly describing the nature of the invention, and it should also have best embodiment for performing the invention. Now moving on further, there are other two fields as well. One is the abstract and another one are the claims. So abstract basically provides the technical information of the invention. It contains concise summary of the subject matter contained in the complete specification. And there are claims. Claims are basically the boundary of any invention, or we can say patent, which the user is going to file. That's why the claims are the most critical part of the patent application. Basically, claims are of two types. One is the independent claim and the next one are the dependent claims. And the first claim is always the independent claim, which is also known as the principal claim. That independent claim clearly defines the essential features of the invention, and the claim is characterized with respect to the prior art, defining all the technical features essential to the invention. And next are the dependent claims. Dependent claims derive antecedents from an independent claim and generally contains optional features of the invention. For instance, the patent application is claiming a feature of measuring the real-time weight of the powder in an apparatus by the powder estimation module. And on that, there is one dependent claim, that is the second claim, where the measuring can happen by using a polarity of load cells. Now we are done with the patent document reading part. Let's move on to the searching part, where we will learn that how to search for the patents which are already published or granted. So this is the image of the Indian patent search database, from where we can find the published patents or the granted patents. It can be searched by various fields, such as by entry. If you know the title of the invention which you are going to search, you can enter the title there. If you know the abstract or some keywords of the abstract, then you can enter the abstract there and you can find the relevant invention. And similarly, if you know the application number, then you can simply enter the application number and the person, or you can easily fetch the details related to that invention or the patent. And the next one is the illustration of the patent number. If you know the patent number of the particular patent, then you can easily find that patent by entering the patent number in the corresponding field. नेक्स्ट वन इज द अबाउट द पेटेंट जनरल. सो पेटेंट जनरल इज वेयर द पेटेंट एप्लीकेशंस आर पब्लिश्ड ऑन वीकली बेसिस. सो बाय विजिटिंग द वेबसाइट ऑफ द पेटेंट जनरल एंड द लिंक इज गिवन देयर. सो सिंपली बाय विजिटिंग दैट वेबसाइट वन कैन फाइंड द डिटेल्स ऑफ द पेटेंट विच आर पब्लिश्ड टिल नाउ इन दिस फॉर्मेट. दिस इज एन इलुस्ट्रेशन ऑफ वन ऑफ द पेटेंट एप्लीकेशन विच इज पब्लिश्ड ऑन 16 जुलाई 2021. एंड आर नेक्स्ट स्लाइड इज अबाउट द ग्रांटेड पेटेंट्स. यू कैन ऑल्सो फाइंड द ग्रांटेड पेटेंट्स ऑन द पेटेंट जनरल. दीज आर ऑल्सो पब्लिश्ड ऑन द वीकली बेसिस इन द पेटेंट जनरल एंड बाय विजिटिंग द सेम लिंक यू कैन फाइंड द ग्रांटेड पेटेंट्स. एंड कंक्लूडिंग टूडे सेशंस, इन केस ऑफ एनी क्वेरीज यू कैन राइट मी ऑन दिस.